morning, boys and girls. Nice to see you again today. Well, today we're going to talk about commandment number 2. And 2 is a very nice number. And so let me think. What comes in 2s? Well, twins come in 2s, right? Twins are 2 people produced by the same mother at the same time. Twins are 2 humans. What else comes in 2s? Yes, boots. They come in 2s. Boots and shoes and socks, they all come in 2s. What else comes in 2s? Well, my earrings come in 2s as well. And so God has a special commandment for his people, and it's commandment number 2. And now Sarah is going to tell us about commandment number 2.
Hi kids, so last week we started talking about the 10 commandments. Remember those? God's 10 very special rules that he gave Moses a really, really long time ago. But we still have to follow those rules today. So for this week's video, we're going to be talking about the second commandment. Do you know what it is? Well, the second commandment is to have no idols and to only worship God. But what does the word idol mean? An idol is anyone or anything that becomes more important than God. Can you believe that? Well, today we're going to be diving into the Action Bible to take a look at a group of people that actually broke that second commandment. Why don't we take a look? The Golden Calf Story. Moses was up on Mount Sinai for a very, very long time, while the Israelites waited down below. After a while, they began to think Moses was not going to come back. So they started to get really nervous, thinking, well, who's going to lead us to the promised land? So they came up with a plan. They wanted to make a statue of a golden calf by melting all of their gold jewelry. Their idea wasn't only crazy, but it was also sinful for the Israelites to worship the image of a calf that Aaron had created. While Moses was still in God's presence, God knew what the people were doing down below. So God told Moses that the people had already forgotten about him. And Moses knew that he had an important job to do, to speak to God on behalf of the Israelites. So God listened to Moses and decided to save them. Moses came down from the mountain carrying the 2 tablets that had the 10 commandments written on them that God gave to him. When Moses saw the Israelites worshiping the golden calf, he got so angry that he threw the tablets to the ground, breaking them into many, many, many pieces. He couldn't believe that the people were so quick to forget about God, even after all the things God had done for them. So after reading that story, how can we follow the second commandment in our lives? Well, we can do this by giving God the worship that he truly deserves. So by obeying him, by studying the Bible, by praying to him, and even by singing worship. By doing all of these things, we show God that he is the most important in our lives.
What's up, everyone? Let's say today's memory verse. I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. Psalm 119:11. Continuing with the 10 commandments, we are going on to number 2. No idols, worship only God. And the second commandment is just like the first, where you don't put anything before God. Simply don't make things to worship them. We know that God is so great and so wonderful, he doesn't even need a picture or a statue to represent him. We cannot worship other idols of other people too, because all the worship goes to God. Now, do you have someone that you look up to? It can be anything from singers to actors to actresses to athletes. And those are examples of idols today. And it can also include money and items that we value. So how can we give God the worship he does deserve? Well, we can just follow the 10 commandments that he gave us and study the Bible and pray to him. Just like our memory verse, I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. Psalm 119:11. So continue studying your Bible verses and make sure you pray to God every day so that all your attention and worship is to him. So what we're going to do next is that we're going to decorate this cup and we're going to stick the second commandment on. We're going to stack them again just like last week to represent the 10 commandments. here is our second commandment cup. And our second commandment is, once again, no idols, worship only God. And I just drew a bunch of orange and yellow polka dots all over it, just kind of matching the theme color of the commandment. And I drew the world because it's like the second commandment where we're not supposed to worship things that are human made or anything that's besides God. I'm going to restack the cups again because last time Aaron knocked them over. So
here's our stacked cups, and as you can see, here's the first one from last week and our second one for this week. And we'll keep going till we reach to the bottom for all 10 of them. Oh my goodness. Aaron, how could you? Oh well. See ya.
Well, thank you, Olivia. Those were great Bible words. Thank you very much. And that was an awesome story, Sarah. Thank you. Today we heard that people should have no idols and worship only God. Our God is the one true God. He's the Lord Almighty. He's the Lord of everything. But have you made Him Lord in your life? And you can make Him Lord today. Romans 10 verse 9 says, say with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, and you will be saved. Yes, you can be a child of God. It's that simple. You say it with your mouth and you believe it in your heart. And today you can pray those words with me. It's a very simple prayer. So let's pray now. Close your eyes and bow your heads, and you can say these words after me. Father in heaven, I come to you now in Jesus' name. I believe that He's your Son and you raised Him from the dead. Thank you, God. Please forgive me for every sin that I have done, everything I've done wrong, God. I want to tell you now, I'm sorry. Come into my heart and into my life. I give it to you. Please lead me and guide me every day, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now you are a child of God. Now you belong to Him. He is Lord of your life. And if you would like to grow up to be a big, strong Christian, then you need to read your Bible, and you need to pray, and you need to go to church. And God will bless your life. It's the best life ever. Being God's child is the best life. Thank you, God, for that. And thank you, Lord, for all the boys and girls who are going back to school this week. Bless them, bless them, bless them in Jesus' name. Bye for now, boys and girls. Have an awesome week.